what will happen. I don't like it.
Noble Caesar!
Truth is,
against the conspirator. Anyone who was under smallest suspicion was ruthlessly killed by the order of Antony and Octavius. In the meantime, Brutus and Cassius had fled to Asia. There they raised an army against Antony and Octavius. But all was not well between the friends. Brutus accused Cassius of taking bribes.
I don't care what you say.
If Caesar was alive today, he wouldn't dare have upset me like this.
You would not have dared tempt him. Remember Ides of March? Did not great Caesar bleed for justice? And one of us who killed him for his corruption now fill our hands with bribes?
Don't presume too much on a friendship. I may do something that I may not like.
You have already done something that you should regret. Above all, Portia is dead. She could not endure my absence. And the grief that Antony and Octavius are getting powerful day by day. She swallowed fire.
Oh, Portia, what loss.
Don't remind me of it anymore. Here,
I have a letter.
That Antony and Octavius are heading towards us. What do you think of marching to Philippi presently?
I don't think that's a good idea.
Our cause has already ripened. The enemy is increasing every day. We are already at a level that we can only decline.
Well, if that is what you want, then let's proceed.
Philippi.
Well, am I going to see you again?
Yes, of course.
Wait, what are you going? Wait, come back!
On the plains of Philippi, the armies of Antony and Octavius await the upcoming battle. All day long the battle raged, but alas, the sun went down at Philippi. Antony and Octavius emerged victorious. Meanwhile, Brutus and his party lost the battle.
last of all the Romans are dead. Friends, I owe more tears to this man than you can see in my eyes. We are defeated. And it is worthy to kill ourselves right now than letting them kill us. I know my hour has come. Caesar, not stand still. I have not killed you with this much eagerness as I'm going to kill myself right now.
Ooh. It has ended.